Hey folks, welcome to Beyond Our Future, where we discuss space, rockets, exploration missions, and everything in between. In today's video, we'll discuss about China's shocking mega bridge. So, let's begin. The Chinese people have created countless technical wonders in the 70 years since the formation of the People's Republic of China. China's road building has advanced from falling behind other nations in transportation infrastructure to possessing the world's longest high-speed railway mileage and expressway mileage. From planning and constructing the world's first supersized bridge, the Nanjing-Yangtze River Bridge, to erecting the world's longest cross-sea bridge. Let us begin with the world's longest sea crossing, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai Bridge. After 9 years of building, Chinese President Xi Jinping formally opened the world's longest sea crossing bridge. The bridge spans 55 kilometers, or say 34 miles, and links Hong Kong to Macau and the mainland Chinese city of Zhuhai. The bridge cost around $20 billion and was supposed to open in 2016. This behemoth belittles other technical marvels like the Eiffel Tower and Chrysler Building. Construction was plagued by safety difficulties, with officials claiming that at least 18 employees have perished on the project. Let's see, what makes this bridge so unique? It's built with enough steel to create 60 Eiffel Towers and with enough concrete to build 22 Chrysler Buildings. It's also equipped to survive super typhoons and earthquakes of a magnitude of 8. This item is constructed to provide service for a century. Its overall length spans the Pearl River Delta by around 30 kilometers. A 6.7-kilometer portion in the center descends into an underwater tunnel that runs between two man-made islands to allow ships to pass. The remaining portions connect Zhuhai and Hong Kong to the main bridge through link highways, viaducts, and land tunnels. The Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge snaked via an underground tunnel that was supplied by two openings that were designed to resemble islands, running through a lengthy section of the Pearl River Delta. The bustling business hub's 4-mile underwater diversion was necessary to allow ships to pass. China refers to this huge project as the greatest sea bridge in the world. Since 2009, the state has invested $20 billion, but the building has been hampered by many production delays and budget errors, which have sparked criticism. The Pearl River Delta has a massive economy and was named the biggest megacity in the world in 2015. The bridge is another step in connecting the nation's Greater Bay Area, which is currently home to 67 million people, as the waterway already serves as an economic artery between mainland China, Hong Kong, and other former colonial territories. By 2030, 29,000 automobiles per day are expected to cross the bridge, according to a June story in the South China Morning Post, while more recent predictions indicate far less traffic in the near term. The bridge is essential to the government's aims to make the area into an economically powerful city that can compete with Silicon Valley. According to the BBC, the bridge will reduce the 4-hour trip between Zhuhai and Hong Kong to only 30 minutes, while receiving criticism for wasting state resources and endangering employees. Travel in the area was famously difficult due to long journeys. Shorter drives will be advantageous, but at a cost. Private cars need permits to use the bridge, and officials are hoping the spike in demand will help repay some of the enormous investments made in the project. In addition to other inspections, special cameras will be on the lookout for drivers on the bridge who exhibit indications of falling asleep. According to local media, if a driver yawns 3 times, the police will be notified. Additionally, at the intersection, traffic will need to switch to the opposite side of the street. Driving is done on the left in Hong Kong and Macau. However, because the bridge crosses Chinese territory, special merging channels have been constructed to accommodate this. A quota system is used to provide special permits to those who wish to cross the bridge, and a toll will be paid by all cars. Private shuttle buses will travel the route as there is no public transportation that serves the bridge. No rail connection exists. 9,200 cars per day were previously anticipated by the authorities to traverse the bridge. After additional transportation networks were constructed in the area, they later revised their estimates. On the flip side, some local media outlets referred to it as the Bridge of Death. Officials informed BBC News Chinese that 9 employees had also perished on the mainland side in addition to the 9 who had been killed on the Hong Kong side. During construction, hundreds of employees also suffered injuries. Concerns about the effects on the environment were also present. According to environmental organizations, the project could have seriously harmed the local marine life, particularly the highly endangered Chinese white dolphin. According to the Hong Kong chapter of the Worldwide Fund for Nature, Dolphin sightings in Hong Kong waterways have dropped from 148 to 47 during the previous 10 years, and they are no longer present in the seas close to the bridge. According to Samantha Lee, Assistant Director of Ocean Conservation at the WWF, the initiative has caused irreparable damage to the oceans. To consider things financially, the main bridge alone costed $6.92 billion to construct, together with the surrounding connection highways and artificial island. Chinese officials claimed it would boost the economy by up to 10 trillion yuan, but a Hong Kong politician questioned that estimate. The bridge can't support itself if not many automobiles are utilizing it. We would never recover the expense of the structure. The bridge will only generate around $86 million in toll revenue annually, according to a BBC Chinese estimate. In fact, a third of this cash would already be lost to maintenance expenditures for the bridge. The bridge has been derided as a huge white elephant with little promise of generating any revenue. Others claim that it just serves as a symbolic function, guaranteeing Hong Kong's physical connection to the mainland. So, this was it for today, guys. We hope you enjoyed our content. Like and share the video if you did. Subscribe to Beyond Our Future for many more amazing videos. Stay tuned, as we'll be back soon with another informative video for your amusement. Till then, keep exploring.